Today we are going to try and get inside of Brian Laundrie's head a little bit. Not because we want to, but because we need to, in order to understand what this person is all about. But first of all, I want to state that the content of true crime is not appropriate for children below the age of 13. So please be aware of that. And I'm going to take you through some footage about Brian Laundrie. And I did quite a research today to find all kinds of footage to discuss. And we're going to check his bedroom. As you can see, there are several items that are circled. So the first item that we see in this picture is what seems to be a gun. It seems to be a gun in the USA flag. I think it's not a real gun. It is talked about on the internet as if it is a real gun, but I don't think this is a real gun. So that's the first item we see. Here we see a Darth Vader mask. Okay. And here we see a painting of a very violent scene. Let's see a little closer. We see men with sticks beating on other, I don't know if it's men or women, I think men. And you can see here that they're trying to defend themselves, but they're all also in despair. And these are very dominant figures standing over other people, hitting them downwards. So, and they're all black figures. So why would somebody have this up in his room? That's very strange. I mean, why? But we'll get to understand later when we get a more peek, when we get a further peek inside his head. Here below, we see some books of Watchmen, or are they DVDs? I'm not sure. But it is the Watchmen series. So, what else do we see? We see that he had a keyboard, or has a keyboard. So maybe he's into making music. We see a Batman poster. We see a lot of things under his bed, but it seems quite neat for a guy's room. I mean, everything looks very clean and organized. So I don't know if his mother tidied up before the pictures were made by the police. It looks like it was tidied up because this is the only thing that is a little bit out of order. The rest is all very organized. Even the hats here are very organized. So, yeah, I'm very curious about what is inside these boxes. What is inside these boxes? I have no idea. And I'm also very curious about what these other books or DVDs are about. We know that he had a love for Fight Club, the movie, or the books. Possibly they're in here as well. So this was his bedroom. If you guys see anything I don't see, please write it in the comments. Maybe you guys see something that I'm not seeing that could be interesting. We're going into his Instagram because here is a lot of insight in his person. We're starting with the art department here. He was into art. He was an artist, one could say, with his drawings. I'm sitting very near to the kitchen, so sometimes you can hear my refrigerator turn off and on. So we're going to the art department here. So the first first thing we see is this little clip. I want to say something about this clip. Because what do we see? We see a snake type of animal. And he put his name in the length of the mouth. So he wanted attention to the name, possibly. And he wanted to be linked to this image by putting his name here. Now, the animal looks very strange. It looks like a zebra meets snake meets fish, because we see a part of a fish here on top. And the eye looks like a button to me. It doesn't look like an animal's eye. So I looked up the symbolism for a button. What is a button symbol? Button symbols are used for timeline navigation. The only thing I can take out of this sentence, it's very far-fetched, but was he aware he was going to commit a crime and that he put the button on the snake as a way to say to us there's going to be a timeline, and you need to navigate through the timeline. I know it's very far-fetched, but we have to keep all options open in this phase of research. So, very weird that he chose a zebra. And from the mouth of this snake-like figure, there's a leopard. No, not a leopard, a lizard type of animal or snake coming out of its mouth. Now, in ancient history, we know that there were snake-like figures, gods even. There are many statues of them in the Indonesia region, but also in South America. There are certain people who are very into those things about these type of figures and statues in ancient history, because they connect them to aliens. Many of those people believe that those snake-like figures may possibly be people that were designed by aliens. So I know it sounds very weird, but some people believe it. And the fact that there is a fish element in it here, the fin of a fish. In ancient history, there were also statues of fish-like humans who had fish skin on their bodies, and they were also gods. And it's believed that possibly people in those days were visited by aliens who gave them technology or made those people themselves. So the aliens made those people. I know it's very weird, but this is what some people believe. So is he maybe into that? Because that could explain something about what is in his head. Was he into that kind of thing? Because that opens up a whole nother level of consciousness in him and interests. I don't know the answer to that yet. Now, we also see Betelgeuse. What does Betelgeuse stand for? I didn't know, so let's see. With his lustful appetites, his vulgar behavior, and his uninhibited cartoonish antics, he can be seen as symbolizing base desires and uncouth behavior. I'm sorry, I don't know how to say uncouth. He stands in for what is known in psychology as the id, the base and unruly appetites that dominate our unconsciousness. He didn't put this in on accident, right? This is in the middle of the figure of the image. His hands are behind it. This is put over his hands. His hands are moving. So what is he trying to say here? What I see in this definition is lustful appetites. Did he have a lustful appetite for Gabby? Yes, he was her boyfriend. But did he have a lustful appetite in the wrong way? His vulgar behavior. If he killed her, he had vulgar behavior, possibly. And uninhibited cartoonish antics. He makes those kind of cartoonish antics. At least he makes cartoons. We will see that later. And it symbolizes base desires and uncouth behavior. The base and unruly appetites that dominate our unconsciousness. So that is the part of us that we have no control over and is very deeply rooted into our wants and needs. So it's a very basic part of us. The id. Now, what is the id? The id is the part of the mind in which innate, instinctive impulses and primary processes are manifest. According to Sigmund Freud's psychoanalytic theory of personality, the id is the personality component made of unconscious psychic energy that works to satisfy basic urges, needs, and desires. So, if he did kill Gabby, he probably had no control over his basic urges, needs, and desires. But the fact that he references this in this image, he was a person who was very aware of symbolism and of the meaning of things. So this is all intentional. So I'm not putting any conclusions on it here. I'm just giving this as fruit for thought. Let's go on with this film. So what do we see? The head sticks. Oh yeah, I forgot. Oh, wait a sec. I have to go back. How do you go back on Instagram? That's just a terrible thing. You cannot go back. So yeah, what else? The two-headed monster is also a ancient figure. So that's also here, a two-headed monster in a way. So he's... Oh, wait. We also see snakes here. Serpents. The serpent is a universal and complex symbol. It can represent destruction, evil, a penetrating legless essence, and or poison. In the Christian tradition, Satan, in the guise of the serpent, instigated the fall by tricking Eve into breaking God's command. Thus, the serpent can represent temptation, the devil, and deceit. The snake is phallic, but also can be seen as androgynous. The snake can have positive implications too. When intertwined with the tree of life, Christian, it represents good, and it can also be associated with healing and or rebirth as it sheds its skin. Okay, it's complex. It can represent death, destruction, evil, a penetrating legless essence and or poison. Did he poison Gabby? Is my thought about this. In the Christian tradition, Satan instigated the fall by trickling Eve. Now, here we are introducing Satan. I'll get back to that later. And the serpent can represent temptation, the devil, and deceit. So the devil is introduced as well. The snake is phallic. Can also be seen as androgynous, so not female. It represents good. Yeah. Okay. So that was the serpent. So why is he stamping serpents on his shirt? Not once, not twice, but three times. Three times. What is he trying to say? Beetlejuice, snakes, two-headed monster. He added the two-headed monster into the video, as well as the Beetlejuice words. They're not in the original video. In the original video, he's just stamping. Very interesting. So he wanted to give an extra message. This is 62 weeks ago, by the way, but that's a little bit over a year. Well, a year and 10 weeks. So next, the next picture doesn't really say anything for me. Now, this one is important to me. Oh God, so bad this. Oh, I might. Wait. Art. Yeah, now we have to wait again because Instagram is not very flexible in this kind of thing. I have to be fast, so let's see. Yeah, so here we see, this draw my attention because I thought, what is this again? This is very familiar. I've seen it in ASMR videos, in role plays, and I always thought, what is this? This is a scary mask. I don't like it at all. So I looked it up. What does it mean? Let me see to get the right one. New. No. Yes. So I looked up satanic bird face mask because I already was thinking about it might be satanic, what he's into. And I got so many results from this. Here we see the exact, well, let's see if it's exactly the same. You see the little teeth here, little teeth, and let's draw that over there. We see the little teeth here. Let me see if I can get it bigger. See? The little teeth here are the same as here. We see a huge, not an eye, more a hole where an eye should be. Here we see also holes where the eye is supposed to be behind in a mask. So that's interesting.